Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you Scalability Pro, show you it in practice, show you how fast it makes your site, show you specifically what it does. Because we have a few plugins and they all optimize your performance in slightly different ways. So this is the product page for it, okay? What I'll do, first of all, I'll show you the speed that we're talking about. This is our found through demo site. It has about a million products on it. You can see up here, this is uncached page speed. This is query monitor that's installed, and you can see it's 0.04 seconds for database time, 450 milliseconds total time. Refresh the page here just to show you that in practice. Now the parts on the right hand side, that's faster Woo widgets. But what Scalability Pro is actually optimizing is the WP query. That's on this archive page, that's mostly what it's optimizing. Okay, now in order to be able to show you the actual things that each part of the settings optimize, I will disable infinite scroll temporarily, because then we can scroll to the bottom of the page and actually read what query monitor tells us. Okay, so I'll deactivate infinite scroll. Okay, and then so when you install Scalability Pro, the first thing, you visit the settings page and you install these indexes. There's a big button to create the indexes. These indexes, they help various different scenarios. So it could be if you've got imports that are referencing WP Post Meta. It depends if they're referencing values in there, rather than joining on a post ID. There's a variety of different scenarios where these can optimize your website depending on what plugins that you have installed and what you're doing with your site. Now if you deactivate the plugin, you should delete the indexes first. They won't be deleted when you deactivate the plugin, so those indexes will stay on. So that delete button there is there to let you do that. Okay, so they're all the options that you get, they're all grouped into the areas that they help optimize. So optimizing WP query, this is for your archive pages. So an archive is like this slash shop page, but it's also like your blog archive. It's any page that has a list of other articles or posts or pages or whatever. Okay, so I've taken infinite scroll off. Now if I go and look at the queries by caller, then you see here we've got WP query get posts. Okay, now this is what these top options are all optimizing. Okay, so I'll switch them off so you can get a feel for how, what this is, what page, what speed the difference this is making. Yep, switch all four of them off. They all optimize in different ways. You might find that you only have to enable two of them, or maybe three of them, in order to get this speed. And I'll show you that as well. It depends on how you're using your site, but that's them off, okay? And this is what you get with default WordPress WooCommerce. This is without using the WooCommerce widgets. I'll show you that in a separate video with faster Woo widgets. But if you have faster Woo widgets on, sorry, if you have the traditional WooCommerce widgets like the price filter or the category filter, this page will take over a minute to load. But as you can see anyway, with those options off, this page is now taking 6 seconds to load. All right, and if I go to queries by caller again, WP query get posts, we now have 6 seconds for this query. Okay, and specifically this SQL calc found rows, that is calculating the number of items, so it's for pagination. So you see that option here. Okay, and then this order by menu order title, that is the sort order. And there's no left join on this page. There'd be a left join on a different page if I go into it. I'll show you a different page so that I can show you this one working. And yeah, I can't show you this just now because that would be if there was a group by command. Okay, but the top two, anyway, the primary one you want to try is removing the pagination, first of all. Okay, it's probably going to be the one that's going to boost your speed. I'll show you that. I'll take pagination off. Okay, I'll reload that page. Now in our case, it's speeded up a little bit, but we're still getting a table scan because of this order. That means that if we go in and remove the order, remove the sort options, okay, there we go, right? So we're down to 0.45 seconds now. Okay, and then these other ones, the left joins, this is for if you go into like a category or something like this. Let's go into baking. Okay, I'll just refresh that page because we're loading this with Ajax. Yeah, it's actually not that bad. It's when it is the times when it's slow, it's if you're joining to post meta, right? Okay, so if I do another query here, let me go back. I'll go to dogs, dog toys. Yeah, I've got dog toys and I've got blue dog toys. Alright, let me check. Yeah, still joining this. If you look at WP Pro, the WP Query Get Posts, if you see queries that are joining to WP Post Meta, then that's when this will really help and it will really speed things up. Okay. And this one, it's if you see, this group by command is actually needed here, but in some cases WooCommerce will run this group by command even though it's not required. So that's safe to add. You can add that, and there are some cases where it'll speed things up. Now, going through the rest of things quickly, the variations, this is for product detail pages. You'll find that these options up above, depending on what you have on your product detail pages. I've got a product detail page and show you. Let's go to one of these pages. Okay, so you see the page is fast, 0.2 seconds. But depending on what you have on your product detail pages, you might actually be using archives on your product pages. So if you're using widgets or short codes that list other products, maybe you have something in the footer or something like that. It depends what you're doing. But if you're doing archive-based stuff on your product detail pages, then these archive options at the top will also optimize your product detail pages. But then if you have a lot of variations, product variations, this option here will really speed up your product detail pages. Basically what happens is that by removing that count, it makes some work happen through Ajax instead of upfront. It's probably badly worded. I'll get an actual example and I'll upload another video about that when I find the example that I wrote that for in the first place. Now, faster imports, when you're importing items, this deferred term counting, one of the things that WordPress does is it will recount all of your products or posts or articles per category to come up with these counts here. The counts are actually stored in the database for each category and taxonomy and everything. Now, if you're importing 10,000 items without this on, depends if the import tool that you're using has also set up the deferred term counting. But if it hasn't, then you could be recalculating those counts 10,000 times, when it makes much more sense to do the 10,000 items, get them imported, and then recount once. Obviously, right? It saves a lot of CPU and a lot of disk. So if you stick that on, it's going to speed things up. Now, WooCommerce optimizations, there's, if you have, this is specifically if you have a lot of entries in WP options. So if you have a lot of transients, you might be using a caching plugin or something which stores data in WP options. WooCommerce have written some bad code where they do a like command in order to delete these three kinds of entries that they put into WP options. Now, basically this happens after an update for WooCommerce. So and what happens is basically every, I think it's roughly every 10 minutes or something, on this website, on Foundthrough, we were getting 3 minutes lockout, 180 plus seconds lockout on WP admin. Okay, so that option, highly recommend it. It eliminates those intermittent lockouts. Basically, instead of it, the delete command's taking 3 minutes, it rewrites the one delete command into 3 separate commands, and they're done in less than a second. Now this custom meta select box, this is for your backend WP admin with WooCommerce. And I can show you if I edit a product. I'll just make sure the screen option is on. Custom fields. So you need to make sure custom fields is on to see what this is doing. But down here, custom fields, normally this select box would be populated, and that gets populated when this is not on. And it takes, well, I can run it and show you. Okay, so you see that page was 0.46 seconds. It's not a huge difference, but you'll see if I go in here. Yeah, so this is the command here, so it's added the 0.2 seconds. I mean, I like performance, right? So anything that I can add to performance, I will do. 0.2 seconds does make a difference. I mean, that means that your server is, you know, this is using the CPU and disk. You don't want your server to be using CPU and disk when it doesn't have to. So it doesn't mean that you can't use metadata. It just means that that little select box isn't populated. I'll show you that select box because it's still populated. I haven't refreshed the page yet, right? So it's this, which lets you go and set custom meta, yeah? But now if I refresh it, you see we're back down to 0.4 seconds, 0.39. Now the select box is gone, but you can still just type in the name of the metadata if you want to add any metadata. Okay. Now, next option. Okay, so the Woo dashboard, this one's for you guys that have got lots of orders. If you're an affiliate, then this won't apply to you, this one. But if you have a lot of orders in your database, then WooCommerce has this dashboard widget that they add by default onto WP Admin. And now that dashboard is slow. So removing this basically speeds up WP Admin. And if you're running that calculation, it's basically calculating how much money you've made in the past month. It shows you a little graph, but if you're running that calculation, that means that you're thrashing your disks and thrashing your CPU, so that means you're affecting your users. So if you've got a lot of orders, remove that. You can still jump into WooCommerce and go to reports, so you know it's you can generate reports and look at your profits or whatever whenever you need to, or your revenue. Now this part here, this is for, it's not actually just for WooCommerce, so that's badly named as well, I need to fix that, but it's for all archive lists in the back end. Okay, so when I list all products here, you see it's still not great, brilliantly fast. I've got one more optimization to add here, I think it's about 6 seconds, yeah. But what this is doing is the parts that are slow here, right, is generating this, which is your post status. It's generating these counts, and it's bad code because it actually runs two table scans here, because it counts for all and then it counts by type, when it actually could calculate all based on the second query that it runs. The other ones that it does remove are these filter by category, so that drop down list has been removed, and filter by product type, that's been removed. Okay, if you need them, then obviously don't choose that, and those will come back. I'll show you the speed that you get. Again, it's not it's a bit of a difference. I'll rerun it. 6.2 was what we were on, and then with those counts, let's see where are we at. 6.52. Yeah, I mean it's because of that last one, because the database is caching, it's fetched all the data from that whole table scan into memory, so it's less than half a second optimization. But once I get this fixed, which is coming, it should be next week maybe, then this page will load in under a second, probably about half a second, because that's the last table scan on that page. Okay, so that's what that option is, and that is what that will do shortly. It will also fix that post status. Okay, and then this separate part, this is so there are cases where there's joins to WP Post Meta and it's joining on the value equaling something. So there's a field in the WP Post Meta table called meta value, and what they do is they say it's a number, right? So they're checking that the meta value equals 6, and they're casting meta value to an integer and then checking to see if it equals 6. Now if you do that, it means that you can't use an index on the meta value field. Okay, so it depends. I'm gonna list up a numbers of the situations where these occur so that you can find so it makes it easier for you to know whether you should switch this on or not. But it's safe anyway, so if you want to switch it on, it's a good idea. Okay, but that's all the options, and basically what you get is, what you end up with is, let's just make sure everything's still on. What you end up with is a really fast site. I'll go back to the front end and show you. So this is our demo shop. And I'll switch, in fact, I'll switch back on auto infinite scroll. And I'll reload. Okay, so you see as we scroll down, it just keeps loading, yeah? And that's the kind of speed that your users want and expect, yeah? If you don't have this kind of speed, they're leaving. So that's what Scalability Pro does. Now, bear in mind, okay, that if you're using the traditional WooCommerce, sorry, I didn't mean to highlight that. If you're using the traditional WooCommerce filters, then Scalability Pro on its own isn't going to help you. You need to get the faster WooWidgets plugin as well. So you can get that as part of the plugin pack. I've made 4 plugins available in the plugin pack at a discounted price as well. But basically, the price filter is the worst one. I'll show you that in a separate video. But the price filter adds like 60 plus seconds to this page, whereas the category filters, they add like 5 or 6 seconds. The attribute filters from WooCommerce, they don't add anything, but they're not compatible with faster WooWidgets. So you have to use one set of widgets or the other, unfortunately. That's just the way it is. But anyway, I'll show you the faster WooWidgets in a separate video. And if you've got any questions about Scalability Pro, so from the product page, we have the frequently asked questions section here. So just fire in and ask a question, and I will keep updating the FAQ with answers as people ask. And obviously this one here, this question was somebody that hadn't switched on Scalability Pro. But hopefully this video anyway will show you how to actually use it and what all the settings are doing. And there's more to come. But if you want to get hold of this plugin, you can find it over at WP Intense. That's the website, wpintense.com. And the performance plugin pack is what you really want. It includes Scalability Pro, faster WooWidgets, auto infinite scroll, and super speedy search. I look forward to answering any of your questions, and see you on the site.